let's take a look at the mark of the beast. Let's read, turn your Bibles to Revelation chapter 13. And we're going to start at the 16th verse. Okay, let me try to hold this straight so you can read also, so we can both read this. And get an understanding. Let's try to get an understanding about this. And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or their foreheads. Let's take a look at that. Let's break it down. And he calls it all. It's saying that he's causing everybody to take it. He meaning the Antichrist. He's causing everybody to take it. And the book of Revelation is telling you about the mark of the beast. So the beast, which is the Antichrist, he's causing all, both small and great. That means no matter how, where you are in society, your status in society, small or great, like, you know, he's still causing all, the young, the old, the rich, the poor. And we're actually reading about it. And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor. That means it doesn't matter if you're rich, a millionaire, billionaire, or poor. He's causing all, free and bond. That means if you're incarcerated or if you're free, if you're locked up or you in jail or you in prison, if you're incarcerated, he still wants you to take the mark. If you're rich or poor, if you're a billionaire or homeless, middle class, upper class, lower class, it doesn't matter. He's causing everybody to take this mark, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead. So the mark is going to be in your right hand. The Bible says specifically where the mark will be. It's going to be in your right hand or in their or in your foreheads. So this is what I believe, that the system, the beast system, is going to be where you can buy or sell. They're going to scan either your hand or they're going to scan your forehead. So let's read verse 17 to get a better understanding. Verse 17, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark. So basically it's saying that you, during this period of time in history, no one can buy or sell save he that had the mark. Only those that take the mark can buy and sell. Now let's read it one more time. And that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast. So you have to have the mark or the name of the beast, which is the Antichrist, or the number of his name. So the mark, the name of the beast, and the number of his name. Verse 18, here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast. So it's saying count. The book of Revelation, like, he is telling us, like, the number, like, here's wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast. It is the number of a man, which is the Antichrist. And his number is 666. Basically, it's saying 666. The number of the Antichrist will be 666. The number of this mark is 666. The number of the beast, and this is basically, it's describing the Antichrist. So let's review this. When it says he calls it all, I please understand that he's causing the whole earth, everyone. He causing all to have this. It's like the way, that's why they pushing for one world currency, one world government, one world religion. This is the Antichrist system. I want you to please understand that this is the Antichrist system, to have one currency, and they pushing for one currency right now, because that's why they trying to get rid of cash. One reason they trying to get rid of cash is because cash, it cannot be tracked. Cash, it cannot be monitored. It goes from hand to hand. It's not taxed by the government. Like, you know what I'm saying? They can't trace it. But I want you to understand how the Antichrist is causing all, everybody, the young, old, babies, infants, everybody. He's causing all, both small and great, rich and poor. It doesn't matter your status. Look at it. He's causing the rich and the poor. That's everybody. When the Bible says, and he calls it all, it's everybody. The rich, the billionaire, millionaire, the poor, the homeless, free and bond, those who are rightfully free in the free world, or bond. They locked up, they incarcerated, they're in prison, they're in jails to receive a mark in their right. It's going to be in your right hand, specifically the right hand or in their foreheads. So I just want to bring this point up. A lot of people say, oh, the Bible this, the Bible is that. But the Bible is actually telling you how it's going to be. What to look for, what is to come. The book of Revelation, that means unveiling, the apocalypse, is telling you things that are hidden. It's Revelation means the unveiling. This is like, you can't just disregard this book, man. You can't, like, it's basically telling what is to come. And you notice how in verse 18 it says, here is wisdom. Like, you have to have this type of wisdom. Ask God for this type of wisdom. It said, let him that hath understanding not only get wisdom, but get understanding. You know, get understanding about the beast. Get understanding about the Antichrist. Get understanding about his number, which is 666. You know, I guess I will leave this right here. Oh, yeah. Let me tell you some things that God, some revelations that God gave me about the Antichrist. I saw the Antichrist take down Dr. Martin Luther King's statue. I think it's in Georgia somewhere, Stone Mountain, Georgia, or something like that. I saw him take down Dr. Martin Luther King's statue. I saw him go to Jerusalem and proclaim that he's God. And I saw him go to the place in Mecca where the Muslims, that black stone, where they walk around, they march around that stone, they kiss it, they pray to it, and, you know, I saw him go there and proclaim that he's God, like he's the God of, you know, the earth. Like, he's God Almighty. He was proclaiming it. He went to Jerusalem and proclaimed this. He went to even Mecca and proclaimed that he was God.